Good morning and welcome to our service this morning. It's a bit cold here in church, but it will be very warm next week when we are allowed to start meeting in person again. We are going to be using the same booking in system that we did before this period of lockdown. So that's through our website or through the links on the emails that are sent to you. And I'm looking forward to seeing the church full as we can safely have it again. So we're looking to do that. And we'll also be live streaming from next weekend. So the links will be sent to you as well. But welcome to our service today on this Advent Sunday. It's a day when we begin our preparation for the coming festival of Christmas, a day when we begin our waiting for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So as we gather, let's prepare ourselves to worship God together.
O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Reveal among us the light of your presence, that we may behold your power and glory. Blessed are you, sovereign God of all. To you be praise and glory for ever. In your tender compassion, the dawn from on high is breaking upon us to dispel the lingering shadows of night. As we look for your coming among us this day, open our eyes to behold your presence and strengthen our hands to do your will, that the world may rejoice and give you praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. A Song of the King's Glory. The earth is the Lord's and all that fills it, the compass of the world and all who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and set it firm upon the rivers of the deep. Who can ascend the hill of the Lord, or who can rise up in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and a pure heart, who have not lifted up their soul to an idol, nor sworn an oath to a lie. They shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a just reward from the God of their salvation. Such is the company of those who seek him, of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O gates, be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord who is mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and for ever. Amen.
Emmanuel, Emmanuel, The response to Psalm 80. Turn us again, O God. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. Hear, O Shepherd of Israel, you that led Joseph like a flock. Shine forth, you that are enthroned upon the cherubim, before Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh. Stir up your mighty strength and come to our salvation. Turn us again, O God, show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. O Lord God of hosts, how long will you be angry at your people's prayer? You feed them with the bread of tears. You give them abundance of tears to drink. You have made us the derision of our neighbours, and our enemies laugh us to scorn. Turn us again, O God, show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. Let your hand be upon the man at your right hand, the son of man you made so strong for yourself, and so will we not go back from you. Give us life, and we shall call upon your name. Turn us again, O God, show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence, as when fire kindles brushwood, and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down, the mountains quaked at your presence. From ages past no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways. But you were angry, and we sinned. Because you hid yourself, we transgressed. We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy cloth. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you, for you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you are our potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity for ever. Now consider, we are all your people. This is the word of the Lord.
A song of the wilderness. We say together, lift up your voice with strength, O herald of good tidings. The wilderness and the dry land shall rejoice, the desert shall blossom and burst into song. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weary hands, and make firm the feeble knees. Say to the anxious, be strong, fear not, your God is coming with judgment to save you. Then shall the eyes of the blind be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then shall the lame leap like a hart, and the tongue of the dumb sing for joy. For waters shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The ransomed of the Lord shall return with singing, with everlasting joy upon their heads. Joy and gladness shall be theirs, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Lift up your voice with strength, O herald of good tidings.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you, because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Now it is time to awaken out of sleep, for the night is far spent and the day is at hand. Now is our salvation nearer than when we first believed, for the night is far spent. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness and put on the armour of light, for the day is at hand. Put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh, for the night is far spent and the day is at hand. We say together, look towards the east, O Jerusalem, and see the glory that is coming from God. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Look towards the east, O Jerusalem, and see the glory that is coming from God.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, as we watch together for his coming, let us pray together for the church and for the world. Lord, strengthen and guide your church in its mission to the world, that sinners may be alerted to repentance and many may be brought to the joy of living in your love. When the pressures of the day fragment our peace, keep us watchful and alert, both for ourselves and the world. Lord, come to us. Live in us now. Lord, we pray for the whole created world and its peoples, that no evil may thwart your will, but that rather your kingdom may be established and your will be done. When false values are paraded among the true, keep us watchful and alert, both for ourselves and our young. Lord, come to us. Live in us now. Lord, bless this parish and all who serve our community, that we may strive each day to align our lives with the life of Christ, who saves us from sin. When our tight schedules leave no time for being merely available, keep us watchful and alert, both for ourselves and for those who need a listener. Lord, come to us. Live in us now. Lord, we pray for all who suffer mentally, physically, and spiritually, for those who see no further than immediate material comforts and do not realize their spiritual poverty. when the injustice of the world laughs at our insignificance, keep us watchful and alert, both for ourselves and for all who rely on our solidarity with them. Lord, come to us, live in us now. We commend to your love all who have completed their life on earth, that they may rest in your peace and share your risen life. We remember Ivy Cork, Francis Lafferty, and Iris Goddard, whose year's mind falls around this time. Lord, come to us, live in us now. Thank you, Lord, for the richness of your companionship, for the joy and peace your constant presence gives. When we begin to take the wonder of your creation for granted, keep us watchful and alert, both for ourselves and for every person you cherish. Lord, come to us, live in us now. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Our collect prayer for today, Advent Sunday. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and to put on the armour of light now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal. Through him who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
But in those days, after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens shall be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds, with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of the heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey. When he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn. Or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly, and what I say to you, I say to all. keep awake.
Little Stevie sat down to write a letter to God asking for a baby brother. He started the letter, "Dear God, I've been a very good boy." Then he stopped and thought, well, God won't believe that. So he screwed up the paper, threw it away and started again. "Dear God, most of the time I've been a good boy." Again, he stopped in the middle of writing his letter and said, God won't be moved by this. So again, he screwed up the paper and threw it into the bin. Stevie then had an idea. He went into the bathroom, grabbed a towel and brought it back into the living room, laid it on the couch. He then went up to the mantelpiece, reached up and brought down a statue of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the mother of Jesus, that had been on his mantelpiece in the family for as long as he could remember. Stevie then placed the statue in the middle of the towel, gently folded over the edges. He brought it to the table, took another piece of paper, and began writing his third letter to God. "Dear God, if you ever want to see your mother again..." Stevie wanted God to act, and he wanted him to act now. He didn't want to wait for God's time. He wanted it in his time. So often we are like that in our lives. The four Sundays of Advent tell us to prepare, but perhaps more importantly this year, they also tell us to wait. Christmas isn't here yet, just wait. Most of us do not like to wait. Someone once said, "I need to take a lesson in patience. Does anyone know where I can take a crash course?" In a certain orchestral number by Joseph Haydn, the flute player is supposed to sit quietly for 74 measures and then come in exactly on the upbeat of the 75th. Gerald Johnson, historian and writer, plays the flute in the Baltimore Symphony Orchestra. He says that a composer who expects someone to wait that patiently and perform that precisely is looking for a rare individual. Because when we wait, we've got to admit some things are not under our control. And most of us like to believe that we are in control. If we work hard enough, if we are sufficiently prepared, if we just concentrate, if we can work on life, then we can make life work. And to a point, we can. There are some things, however, that can't be hurried. Recuperation from surgery, the grief process, a young person learning responsibility. John R. Claypool wisely said, "Let's face it, there are two kinds of reality in this world of ours. There are things that you have to work for, and there are things that you have to wait for." I don't know who Claypool is, but I know whoever he is, he's right. There are things that you have to work for, and there are things that you have to wait for. But we don't like to wait. We could all learn a little from Winnie the Pooh. Compared to his friends, Pooh Bear remains unfrazzled, down to earth, calm, and above all, patient. Owl constantly pontificates, showing off his wisdom, but never solving problems or making things work. Rabbit is an impetuous activist, always calculating and very clever, but always out of touch with the reality of the situation. Eeyore the donkey frets and complains, but never brings himself to action. Pooh, on the other hand, doesn't force things or try too hard. When upset, he simply states, "Oh, bother." He knows that if he remains relaxed and sensible and in touch with the important things in life, doing everything he can in a situation, things will work out. In a wonderful little book called The Tao of Pooh, we find the following advice. Within each of us, there is an owl, a rabbit, an Eeyore and a Pooh. For too long we've chosen the way of owl and rabbit, and now, like Eeyore, we complain about the results, but that accomplishes nothing. If we are smart, we'll choose the way of Pooh. Children can often be more patient than grown-ups. There's a story of a small child standing at the bottom of a shopping centre escalator, intently looking at the handrail. The small boy would simply not take his eyes away from the handrail. Someone asked him, "Are you lost?" "No," he said, "I'm just waiting for my chewing gum to come back." The ability to wait is one of these childlike qualities that says there are some things in life that I cannot control, but someone is in control of them. We don't like to wait because that means we have to admit we're not in control of everything. Faith is the conviction that there is one who is in control, whose nature is love. Sometimes that is faint hope to hold on to. Fatigue and desperation suggest just give up. How often we need to remember the words of the psalmist, "Delight in the Lord, and he'll give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass." We need to hold on to our faith as we wait. George MacDonald failed as a parish priest. Humiliated, he became a writer. And for years, he wrote only with a modest success. But finally, his skill as a writer of fantasies, children's stories, and poetry won him acclaim. He became one of the best known and most loved English writers of his time. It was one of MacDonald's books that gave C.S. Lewis the first nudge towards Christianity. Lewis said of him, "I know hardly any other writer who seems closer or more continually close to the spirit of Christ himself." MacDonald himself said, "The principal part of faith is patience." It takes humility to wait, to admit we're not in control, and it takes faith to wait. But also, by yielding control of our lives and trusting in God, waiting itself can become a creative strategy for dealing with life's disappointments. The day after Easter, the parish priest paused for a moment at the top of the steps leading from his church to the avenue below, now crowded with people rushing to do their jobs. Sitting in her usual place, inside a small archway, was the old flower lady. At her feet, the flowers she sold were spread out on a newspaper. The flower lady was smiling at the world, her wrinkled face alive with joy. The vicar started down the stairs to go home, and then, on an impulse, turned and picked out one of the old lady's flowers. As he took it from her, he said, "You look happy this morning." "Why not?" she answered. "Everything is good." She was dressed so shabbily and seemed so very old that her reply somehow startled him. "You have no troubles?" he responded. "Well, you can't reach my age and not have troubles," she replied. "Only it's like Jesus and Good Friday." The vicar waited for her to continue. "You see, vicar, on Friday, Jesus was crucified. It was the worst day for the whole world. And when I get troubles, I remember that. And then I think what happened 3 days later. Easter, our Lord arising. So when I get troubles, I've learnt to wait 3 days, and somehow everything gets all right again." And she smiled a goodbye. That old flower lady's advice would help many of us. Give God a chance to help. Wait 3 days. Psalm 27, we read, "Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart." And then in Psalm 37, "Those that wait upon the Lord shall inherit the earth." Again, Isaiah chapter 40, Those that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. The word wait appears over 100 times in our scriptures. Sometimes there is nothing else that we can do. Like the early church, we can only wait and watch and work. Such waiting requires humility and faith in order for us to persevere. Sometimes, however, waiting can be a strategic response to a difficult situation. Remember Jesus and Good Friday, said the old flower lady. Give God a chance to help. Wait 3 days. Our waiting in the current pandemic has been significantly longer than 3 days. And yet the season of Advent teaches us that the end of our waiting, there is that promise of God, Emmanuel, God incarnate. And our past experiences tell us that in the midst of the waiting, God truly is with us. So this Advent time, let us prepare and let us find peace in our waiting. Amen.
Our notices for today start with an invitation to join us for coffee and chat over Zoom after this service. Details are on the screen, or you can just use the link, click on the link that was sent in the email. It'd be wonderful to see you, even if just for 5 or 10 minutes. Just come along and say hi. It'd be nice to see as many people there as we've had over the last couple of weeks. So that would be good if you could join us for coffee after the service. Our sponsored baubles scheme for our Christmas tree this year is finishing at the end of November. So that is, this Sunday will be the last Sunday that we'll be able to sponsor baubles for the Christmas tree this year. We'll be opening up the scheme again in January so that baubles for future years can still be added to the tree. But if you want a bauble on the tree this year, then please do contact Jane O'Sullivan and she'll give you the details and let you know how that can be done. For our carol service this year, we are putting together a congregational carol, and we're working technically on how we can do that. But we are also trying to put together a congregational Lord's Prayer. So if you go to our website and go to Carol Service 2020, it's one of the tabs on the website, you'll hear a short explanation of what you're to do, and there's a recording of me saying the Lord's Prayer and a copy of the Lord's Prayer for you to say along to. And what we'd like you to do is to record yourself saying the Lord's Prayer and then send that to me, and I'll add all the individual Lord's Prayers together and try and make one copy of the Lord's Prayer with all of us saying it together. So I explain it far better on the website than I have just now. So please do join us for that if you're able to. There are lots of ways of doing it. If you're not technically proficient at doing it, then you can ring myself or Peter Schofield or Anne Skip, and we've all got the facility to help you record that over the phone so that we can all join in saying the Lord's Prayer for our recorded carol service this year. Please do let us know if you've got birthdays and celebrations coming up, and please do read the weekly notice sheet. There are lots more notices and lots more information on the notice sheet. So please do read those and take part in the Advent prayer diaries that are being distributed as well. Advent is a time of preparation for Christmas, and in all the other preparations that go on, it is good to use Advent as a time of preparation for the truth of Christmas, God with us, Emmanuel. So please do use those prayer diaries as well. Thank you very much.
Just a child, no warrior, no.
May the Lord, when he comes, find us watching and waiting. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and lives in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you, now and evermore. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.
And on the